Well, all week, we have been introducing you to some hometown heroes. They are getting some very special recognition from the Sacramento Sierra Red Cross. But first, they're coming here to KCRA3. Today, we welcome this woman, Molly Casey. She is a lifeguard who put her skills to the test, actually outside of the pool. And we want to thank you, first of all, for being here. You've got an interesting tale because a lot of the folks we're having on here, you know, saved a person's life. You tried very hard to save this dog's life.
Yeah.
The dog did pass, but you managed to get it to the hospital. Tell me your story.
I was just a normal day. I was babysitting two Yorkies, and I was feeding them. And I went to lock the back door, and I came back, and the little girl Yorkie was on her back with her tongue rolled out. So automatically, I figured she was choking, so...
You knew something wrong. It wasn't like scratch my belly. I mean,
yeah,
you knew something.
I thought it was for a moment, but then she wasn't moving at all, and I didn't see her breathing, so...
My.
I went down, and I scooped the chicken out of her throat, and I gave her two rescue breaths, and they didn't go in, so...
So you kind of held back on your lifeguard training to do this. I mean, is it similar, you know, trying to save a person's life as it would be to be an animal? Same kind of rules apply?
Oh, definitely. I went in that same mindset. As if it were a small child, I went to that training to rescue breaths, and you wait 5 seconds, so they don't go in, then you gotta try them again, put your finger in there and scoop out, mm-hmm. see if there's anything else left in there, which there was. I had to do it a couple times. It was backed up all the way down her esophagus. So she couldn't breathe, but...
Yeah, no, tell me the rule here. I've heard that you don't do the chest compressions anymore. It's just the breathing. Is that correct? Is that...
I wasn't giving her CPR. I was just giving her rescue breaths because
okay.
I didn't think to check her pulse. I mean, it was a dog, so I didn't know where to look exactly.
Yeah,
but I was just trying to get her breathing at, like... because I didn't know how long she hadn't been breathing for.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So. And what did you do? Who do you call when something like this? Did you call 911? Do you call... I wouldn't know what to do. That's...
I didn't either. I called, the information number and asked for the Petco number, and then I got a hold of them, and they gave me the emergency veterinary care number, which is on El Camino, and... as soon as she started breathing, which was miraculous,
get her to breathe again.
I thought she was dead, and then all of a sudden, I felt like an eternity, but after about a minute, she started breathing again.
Wow.
And then I threw a towel on her, and I put her in my passenger seat and drove her over there.
What, was she still kind of a little out of it at that point?
She was a little hazy, but she started... kind of like acting normal
just
again.
Kind of being a dog again.
Yeah.
You got her to the hospital, mm-hmm. and unfortunately she did lose her life, but it wasn't due to, you know, what happened to her with the choking thing. Tell me what happened to that dog.
It turns out that she had a lymphoma disease that had leaked a bunch of fluid around her lungs. So when she was eating, she eats quite quickly. Some of the fluid had gotten in her lungs, and she had a heart attack at the same time. Mm-hmm. And then the chicken in her throat was just a side effect of... What
happened?
That, the heart attack.
Well, obviously, the person... Now, first of all, you were watching your girlfriend's mother-in-law's dogs, mm-hmm. and I would assume that she was very close to these animals.
Yeah.
And they, despite the dog losing their life there at the veterinary hospital, you did what you could to save his life for a while,
yeah.
at least to get the dog to the hospital.
Yeah.
What do you think about folks calling you a hero here?
I think it's really special and stuff. I just did what I automatically was trying to do. I don't know. I just jumped right in. I don't think I'm here. I just wanted to help someone.
Have you ever actually had to use this at a swimming pool before?
I have not had to use it on another person.
Well, it's a dog. You're kind of prepared anyway.
Yeah.
God forbid something happened at a pool.
Yeah.
Thank you, Molly, so much. I appreciate you joining us. And you are a hero in our eyes. Thanks so much. Well, Molly and several other hometown heroes are going to be honored at the Red Cross Hometown Heroes Luncheon. KCRA3's Galston Dart will be the MC. It is from October 13th from noon to 1 p.m. at the Doubletree Hotel in Sacramento. Tickets are $20. For more information, just go to kcra.com/community. Thank